Hello everyone. I hope you all are enjoying your online classes and also learning many different things. So in today's session, we are covering Git and GitHub. In the previous class, you all have many doubts regarding the Git and GitHub. So I hope all those doubts, most of them will be cleared in this class. So starting with Git and GitHub, basically, Git is a popular version control system that track your code. Before this, I want to give you an example. Suppose you are in a team and now you are making any project in which you have to share code. So in that process, you will be facing many problems. So for that, the Git and GitHub is made. So in that, Git will track the code. It will also uses to see who made the changes, and also you can work in the collaboration using the Git. Okay. Beside this, GitHub is a website, hosted website that make the tools which use Git. So before going forward, I want you all to install the Git in your PCs and also sign up in the GitHub, www.github.com, so that we will be proceed a little faster.
Ma'am?
I already done this.
Ma'am?
Okay, those who have already downloaded the Git, please raise your hands.
Ma'am?
Hello, yes.
Ma'am, can you repeat what you said just now?
Actually, I'm asking that those who have already installed the Git in their PCs, please raise your hand, and also who had signed up in the GitHub.
Ma'am, I don't have PC. Can we continue the class?
Can you show the link for download again?
Yes, sure.
Excuse me, ma'am. Can you send the link in chat box?
You can also just write Git download in the Google. You will get the first link. You click there and download that. I'm sharing the link.
Ma'am, can you proceed through mobile phone, ma'am?
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Can you proceed through mobile phone, ma'am, or PC is necessary for this class?
Sorry, I can't hear you properly.
Can we proceed through mobile phone, ma'am, or PC is necessary for this class, ma'am?
Yes, laptop is necessary. You can't do it in your phone.
Okay, ma'am.
And I hope that everyone has connected with their laptops. Those who are not, so please connect with your laptops, because we whatever we are doing here will be in the laptop only.
And we have to sign in GitHub.
Yes, you have to download Git and you have to sign up in GitHub.
Online GitHub,
no? Yes, online GitHub. GitHub is a website and Git is different from the GitHub. Okay. So I'm sharing my screen. I will be also downloading with you the Git, and as I have already signed up. So I hope that it is similar like sign up in the Facebook and Instagram, same thing. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So this was very simple. I just write Git download in the Google, and I press the I click the first link, and the Git had downloaded. So I hope that all you have.
Ma'am, how do we have to open that?
Done this.
Ma'am, please tell the chat boxes we have to pick at the time of installation.
Ma'am.
Keep the default one.
Ma'am. Hello.
Yes.
Ma'am, they are asking how many team members will be working with you. What do we have to select? Hello. And the options are
can
just
you please share your screenshot because it should not ask that.
Yes.
Anyone who is facing some issues, please share a screenshot of your screen in chat box, okay?
So I think that Git is downloading, so we can proceed further and then we will install the Git together, okay? So let it be like that.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, it is asking about how many components you want to install. Like there is like Git LFS while installing associate.git, associate.shpy, check date.
Yes, sir. We'll install along the way and then you can see the options which are, we are selecting. For now, you just have to download the setup, okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so moving forward, download it. We will install it together, okay? So now we have, what are the problems? Why we are using Git? So basically, the problems which we face during the code sharing is when you share the code, there there are many problems which you face. So suppose tum ek hackathon mein baithe ho and you are making a project. So what you will do, tum apne dost se bologe ki yes, you do this HTML page, I will do this HTML page, and in this way, you will distribute the work among yourself. But when you will merge your code, when you will combine your code, you will face many difficulties because all of you are doing this on your PCs, different PCs. So it will be very hard to merge your code at the end. And it will be also very hard to find the errors at which particular line the error is coming. So for that, I am discussing those problems. So the first problem which we face in the real life while sharing the code is the code sharing. Basically, when you write the code, suppose you are two friends. The one of your friend is writing the code of first page. The second one is writing the code of second page. And now one of the second one do not know about the code which he want to include in that page. So basically, मैं बोलना चाहती हूँ कि तुम दो फ्रेंड्स हो, दोनों के दोनों फ्रेंड्स क्या कर रहे हैं, एक दूसरे पेज का कोड लिख रहा है, एक अलग पेज का कोड लिख रहा है. पर ऐसा होता है कभी कभी कि हमें कोड जो होते हैं वो समझ नहीं आते हैं. मीन्स अब मुझे हेल्प चाहिए फर्स्ट फ्रेंड की कि वो मेरे सेकेंड पेज के कोड को लिखे. तो देर आर टू वेज कि वो मेरे पी सी में आके वो टाइप कर दे. बट इफ़ वी आर फार तो वो ऐसा नहीं कर सकता है. तो उसके लिए क्या होगा कि वो अपनी ही पीसी से उस मेरे पेज का कोड लिख दे बिकॉज मुझे वो नहीं आ रहा है. एंड फिर दिक्कत तब होगी जब हम कोड को मर्ज या कंबाइन करेंगे. तो ये प्रॉब्लम जो होती है कोड शेयरिंग की. देन सेकेंड वन इज ट्रेसिबिलिटी. नाउ किसने कौन सा कोड लिखा, मीन्स ये कैसे हम फाइंड करें कि किसने कब कौन सा कोड जो है वो ऐड किया है. सो दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम विच वी फेस कि कभी कभी ऐसा हो जाता है वी हैव अ बग एंड नाउ हम टीम में हैं एंड वी आर सॉल्विंग दैट बग. किसी ने वो बग जो है वो पहले ही मॉर्निंग में सॉल्व कर चुका होता है एंड वो फिर उसके पीसी में ही रह गया वो कोड. हम उसमें फिर दोपहर में लगे हुए हैं. सो ऐसे क्या होता है कि हमें पता नहीं चलता है, हम एक ही चीज़ को बार बार रिपीट भी करते चले जाते हैं. दूसरी चीज कि हमें यह जानना भी जरूरी होता है कौन से टीम मेंबर जो है वो कौन सा कोड लिख रहे हैं. सो दिस इज अ ट्रेसिबिलिटी प्रॉब्लम विच वी फेस वाइल शेयरिंग द कोड वाइल मेकिंग द प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, द थर्ड वन इज मर्जिंग द कोड. मान लेते हैं कि सबने कोड लिख दिया है एंड नाउ अब हमें क्या करना है, उस पूरे कोड को मर्ज करना है ताकि हमारा प्रोजेक्ट कंप्लीट हो पाए. अब प्रोजेक्ट कंप्लीट होने के लिए जब हम कोड को मर्ज करेंगे तो ऐसा हो सकता है कि हाँ किसी तुम्हारे फ्रेंड्स ने द फर्स्ट वन हैज रिटन द फर्स्ट पेज देन सेकंड पेज देन थर्ड पेज एंड फोर्थ पेज के लिए कोड लिखा एंड यू हैव मर्ज दैट कोड. तो ठीक है, लेकिन समटाइम्स जब हम कोई बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट कर रहे होते हैं तो कोई अकेला कोई अकेला जो होता है वो फर्स्ट पेज का कोड नहीं पूरा कर पाता है. सो फॉर दैट यू उसको हेल्प चाहिए होती है और हेल्प करते समय हम कोड इधर उधर कर देते हैं. कोई किसी के पेज का कोड लिख देता है, कोई किसी के पेज का कोड लिख देता है और कोड डिफरेंट हो जाते हैं. सो व्हाइल मर्जिंग हमें बहुत सारे कॉन्फ्लिक्ट फेस करने पड़ते हैं. सो टू रिजॉल्व दैट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट वी विल स्टडी द गेट एंड गेटअप. सो दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम दैट वी फेस व्हाइल मर्जिंग द कोड. द फोर्थ वन इज रिवर्टिंग बैक द कोड. ओके, तो हमारे पास ऑप्शन होता है अंडू का जब हम कोई भी वर्ड फाइल या फिर पेंट इन सब में काम कर रहे होते हैं. सो हम क्या करते हैं, अगर हमने कोई गलती कर दी आगे प्रोसेस करते आगे कुछ भी हम प्रोसेस करते वक्त, तो हम क्या करते हैं कंट्रोल जेड करके अंडू कर देते हैं, रिवर्ट बैक कर जाते हैं. बट इन केस ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट मेकिंग हम ऐसा नहीं कर सकते बिकॉज हम ऐसा अलग अलग बैठ के नहीं कर सकते. बिकॉज हमने कोड लिखा, हमने उसको टेस्ट करा प्रॉपर, उस समय हमें ऐसा लगा कि हाँ ये ठीक है, हमने उसको पूरा कंप्लीट करके दे दिया. बट आफ्टर फ्यू टाइम हमको रियलाइज होता है नो, द प्रीवियस कोड दैट वी हैड रिटन वाज बेटर देन दिस. प्लीज म्यूट योरसेल्फ बिकॉज इट डिस्टर्ब द होल क्लास. ओके, नाउ सो बेसिकली रिवर्टिंग बैक इज समथिंग लाइक कि हमको हमने जो कोड लिखा है वो हमें उस टाइम के लिए अच्छा लगा, बट आफ्टर फ्यू टाइम हमें ऐसा लगता है कि नो, द प्रीवियस वर्जन ऑफ दिस कोड वाज गुड एंड वो सही था, इससे बेटर था. तो अब हम उस कोड को लाना चाहते हैं वापस, बट इट वाज नॉट पॉसिबल कि हम इसको ऐसे ला पाए. सो दैट वाज अ प्रॉब्लम दैट वी फेस. द फोर्थ प्रॉब्लम इज प्रॉपर टेस्टिंग. बेसिकली प्रॉपर टेस्टिंग इज नॉट पॉसिबल when you do the coding essay without using this git and github softwares. So what is proper testing? Proper testing is something like ki tum apne har page ko acche se test kar rahe ho, koi error to nahi aa raha hai and koi bug to nahi aa raha hai, warnings aa rahe ki nahi aa rahe hai. So basically har ek page ko aise test kiya. अगर मैं बोलूँ गेट एंड गेटअप का बिना यूज करके ऐसा कर रहे हैं हम कि प्रॉपर टेस्ट, तो हमें बहुत सारा काम पड़ जाएगा. वी हैव टू डू लॉट ऑफ हार्ड वर्क इन दैट बिकॉज वी विल फर्स्ट टेस्ट द बग्स इन आवर ओन पीसीज. एवरीवन व्हिच इज हु इज इन आवर टीम विल टेस्ट दैट एंड उसके बाद व्हेन वी विल मर्ज द कोड देन ऑल्सो वी विल टेस्ट दैट वेदर द कोड इज वर्किंग प्रॉपरली और नॉट. So we are testing the code multiple and multiple times, but that is not the problem with the git and github. So without git and github there are lots of problem other than this also which we have to face. So agar so for that we are using git and github taki hame in sab problems se hum bach sake. Okay, so अब हम एक प्रॉब्लम का डेमो ले लेते हैं. डेमो आई हैव टोल्ड यू ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट वी फेस, मोस्ट ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स, बट नाउ आई वांट द सॉल्यूशन फ्रॉम योर साइड कि अगर उस पोजीशन में तुम लोग होते देन तुम लोग क्या करते. सो फॉर दैट सपोज दैट यू ऑल हैव फाइव मेंबर टीम इन विच यू आर मेकिंग अ प्रोजेक्ट एंड यू हैव टू मेक अ वेबसाइट और एनी प्रोजेक्ट. And now you have those problems, those five problems, and now you have to solve this problem. How you will solve this problem without using git and github? Those who want to answer can raise their hands. And the problems were these: code sharing, traceability, merging code, reverting back, and proper testing. In my cell topics, these are the questions which you have to answer in your own way. कि तुम जब गेट एंड गेटअप यूज नहीं कर रहे होते, व्हेन यू विल नॉट यूजिंग गेट एंड गेटअप, यू आर मेकिंग द प्रोजेक्ट, देन हाउ यू विल बी डूइंग योर प्रॉपर टेस्टिंग ऑफ योर प्रोजेक्ट, हाउ यू विल बी एबल टू डू द रिवर्टिंग बैक, हाउ यू विल मर्ज योर कोड. तुम लोग अलग अलग पीसी में काम कर रहे हो, अलग अलग पेज बना रहे हो, एंड देन अगर तुम्हारे पास गेट एंड गेटअप नहीं है, बिकॉज ये पहले से तो था नहीं, इट हैड कम अभी अभी आया है, सो तब तुम क्या करते. सो आई वॉन्ट द आंसर्स फ्रॉम योर साइड. दोज हु वॉन्ट टू आंसर कैन रेज द हैंड. Yes, Akash.
Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, the first three problems, so can be solved by uploading our files to Google Drive or any other drive. But the last two, including the reverting back and the proper testing, that we cannot do.
First one is your code sharing.
Yes, ma'am. If we upload our codes to the Google Drive or any other cloud platform and give access to all of the team members, then we can share the code.
This could be possible if your code, मतलब अगर तुम्हारे कोड के मेमोरी ज़्यादा नहीं है, मतलब ज़्यादा मेमोरी वाला कोड हुआ, then you can't do this. For that you will need extra space.
Actually, in this case, you have to upload multiple files and then download it and merge it. But in the case of Git, you are only uploading a single file, and then the files will be getting updated by each and every code. Got it, Akash?
Yes, sir. Sir, but okay, हाँ, yes, sir. ठीक है, got it.
Okay, anyone else? जो I want the answers from your side. Please answer. ऐसा नहीं है possible नहीं है, because before the Git, the people were used to people face these problems and they find the solution. They used to do these whatever solution that will be coming in your mind will be already done by those people. No one else? Okay, we can move ahead then. Basically, ये सब जो problems थी, इन सब के यही solutions थे कि हाँ, हम ऐसे drive में upload करें and हम ऐसे code को share करें कहीं पे. लेकिन उससे क्या होता था, बहुत सारा डेटा वेस्ट होता है कि यहाँ से वहाँ कोड जा रहा है एंड पूरा कोड फिर चेंज हो गया. एक फाइल में तीन लाइन चेंज हो गई, पूरा कोड फिर से भेज रहे हैं. सो लाइक दैट. सो दिस वॉज द प्रॉब्लम एंड द सोल्यूशन टू दिस इज अ मैनेजिंग सॉफ्टवेयर दैट कैन सेव अ चेक पॉइंट्स. बिकॉज रिवर्ट बैक करना तभी पॉसिबल है जब तुम्हारे पास चेक पॉइंट्स बने हो कि हाँ, हम कहाँ तक रिवर्ट बैक करें. ओके, वन स्टेप टू दिस, वन स्टेप टू दिस. सो दैट चेक पॉइंट्स शुड बी क्रिएटेड. ओके, सो बेसिकली एन ऑनलाइन होस्टेड सर्विस वेयर वी कैन कोलैबोरेट विद अ फ्रेंड इज द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम एंड दैट वी आर गोइंग टू दैट वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट. ओके, सो आई इन द फर्स्ट स्लाइड आई टोल्ड यू दैट गिट इज अ वर्जन कंट्रोल सिस्टम. That is VCS. So basically, what is version control system? So version control system is basically that tracks the file that manages the changes to a software code. तुम जो भी कोड डालते हो कहीं उस सॉफ्टवेयर में, वो कोड तुम्हारा ट्रैक करता है. सपोज तुमने एक पेज बनाया है, उस पेज में तुमने थ्री लाइन्स लिखी हैं. वो जो थ्री लाइन्स हैं, वो तुमने अपने नाम से पुश की. सपोज पर्सन वन, तो ट्रैक करता है, ओके, पर्सन वन हैज चेंज इन दिस फर्स्ट फाइल एंड ही हैड एडेड थ्री लाइन्स, तो वो चेंज शो कर देता है. एंड फिर दूसरा पर्सन आया, टीम मेंबर, उसने वहां पे फाइव लाइन्स और ऐड कर दी. फिर से वो ट्रैक करेगा कि ओके, पर्सन टू हैड एडेड द फाइव लाइन्स, एंड वो टाइम भी बताएगा कि ओके, इतने बजे उसने फाइव लाइन ऐड की. सो बेसिकली दैट द वर्जन कंट्रोल सिस्टम डज. ओके, version control system are the software tools that help software teams manage changes. So what are the example of version control system? Examples of version control system are Git, that we are going to use today, subversion system, and many others. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, 2 minutes. Okay, so in the version control system, the example of version control system, the one of the example was Git. So what is Git? Don't confuse between Git and GitHub. First of all, we will covering the Git, then we will move to GitHub. Okay, so what is Git? Git is basically free and open source. So Git is simple like your command prompt. It is basically Linux type, okay? So Git is a free and open source distributed version control system. I told you what is version control system. That traces who had made it the changes, okay? And this system is designed to handle everything from small to a large project with speed and efficiency. And in nowadays, this is used by many developers. And if you want to shift in this development field, you should be about the Git. Okay, so now why do we need Git? Basically, we had discussed about the problems, that what are the problems that we face, and for that we need the managing software, and we reach here studying the Git. So basically, Git work on the new code without there are main reasons why we need Git. The one of the reason is that it code without hampering the previous code. जो भी तुमने पहले का कोड लिखा हुआ है उस कोड को ये कुछ भी नहीं करता है. सपोज तुमने एक ही पेज को, यू हैव रिटन द वन पेज 5 times बाय एडिटिंग, वट एवर यू हैव डन, यू हैव रिटन द वन पेज, द कोड ऑफ द वन पेज 5 times, फिर भी तुम देन ऑल्सो यू कैन शिफ्ट टू द फर्स्ट पेज, मीन्स द फर्स्ट द कोड यू हैव रिटन द फर्स्ट टाइम, राइट? So it doesn't hamper the previous code. The second one is to maintain the code or logs. It also maintains the logs that when you have changed the first page, which line you have changed, and it also tells you that कौन कौन सी लाइन तुमने हटाई है, विच लाइन यू हैव डिलीटेड. सो इट इज़ नॉट लाइक दैट कि तुम्हारे डिलीटेड कोड्स को भी ये हटा देता है, नहीं, इट ऑल्सो कीप दैट डिलीटेड कोड्स. ओके, देन द थर्ड वन इज कोलैबोरेट विद अदर कोडर्स, एंड दिस इज वॉज द मेन रीजन दैट कोड अदर वी हैव टू कोलैबोरेट विद अदर कोडर्स, बिकॉज अगर हम अकेले काम कर रहे हैं देन वी कैन, हम अपने सारे पेजेस खुद संभाल सकते हैं, बट वेन वी आर वर्किंग इन अ टीम, we need something like Git. Okay, so basically this is what we have learned about the Git, and there are many terms which you have to study, such like repository. So basically, what is a repository? I want to tell you about the repository. So before that, let's move to the installing the Git. We have downloaded that, let's install that. And those who are facing the problems in the options can see that what are the options which I am selecting. Actually, it is already all the options are already selected. There is no problem in that. Open your .exe file. Click on the yes. Okay, then you will see this type of license. There's no. If you want to read, you can read this. Click on next. This is the location where you the Git will be installed. So just click on next. Ignore that pop-up, because I have already installed the Git. That's why it is showing. Yes.
मैम जस्ट रिकॉर्डिंग मैम मिलेगी. हेलो मैम, मैम आपने अपना फोन म्यूट कर लिया.
अरे यार,
मैम जस्ट रिकॉर्डिंग मिलेगी मैम.
प्लीज टाइप.
सर ही इज आस्किंग अबाउट क्लास रिकॉर्डिंग.
सर वो पूछे रिकॉर्डिंग मिलेगी नहीं मिलेगी.
Yes, you will get the recording of this class.
It's on the YouTube channel, so there you can actually record it.
मैम आपने विंडोज पोर्टेबल में जाके क्लिक किया था या फिर ऊपर वाले ऑप्शंस में
इन द डाउनलोडेड ऑप्शन
सी फॉर इंस्टॉलिंग गिट यू डोंट हैव टू सेलेक्ट एनी अदर ऑप्शन जस्ट गो विद द डिफॉल्ट एंड कीप क्लिकिंग ऑन नेक्स्ट ओके
दोज हु हैव नॉट इंस्टॉल्ड द गिट कैन इंस्टॉल गिट विद मी इट इज वेरी इजी एक्चुअली Just click on the next button, then next, again next, 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 next. So this is installing, okay? Who have installed the, can you raise your hand, those who have installed the Git in their PCs and also have signed up in the GitHub?
Also, there was someone who was on Mac operating system. Anyone who is on Mac operating system, you first have to install Homebrew on your system. So for that, you can, I'll paste a command. You can just use this command in your macOS terminal. And after that, you can again use the brew install command.
Why these? Why you all have not downloaded and installed the Git? Install it because it will be a requirement of this class. After this, we will be we will writing commands. So it will be difficult for you for those who have not installed the Git yet.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, after installing it, it is showing two options like launch Git Bash and second one is view release notes. So what to say?
No, you can just click on finish.
Just click on finish.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
How can we sign in? Where we have to sign in?
You have to sign in www.github.com. And those who have not installed the Git yet, please raise your hand. And those who have installed the Git can down your hands. I will be helping those who have not installed the Git yet, because that is the necessary.
मैम ये लास्ट में दो ऑप्शन दिखा रहा है लॉन्च गिट बैश व्यू रिलीज नोट्स इन दोनों में से कोई बॉक्स क्लिक नहीं करना
No, just click on the finish.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I have downloaded Git, but still not installed it. Please, can you tell the installation process?
Just click on that, double click on that. A pop-up will appear. Yeah. Click yes.
Yes,
then
ma'am.
Next. Then next, next, next. And then
I have downloaded it. But next, what to do next?
Okay, share your screen. Could you share your screen?
Yes, just a second, ma'am.
Or you can just send this screenshot. Hello.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, actually, there was today's Nature Club interview. So I have came late and lost the plot of whole meet. So what to
okay.
do?
No problem. Just go to the Google, write download Git and download that. Just downloading the Git. Okay. And those who have not downloaded the Git yet, please raise your hand and send me the screenshot, whatever you are facing, whatever difficulties you are facing.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
All those who don't have a laptop, see, you have to have a laptop for this because you will have to do the coding part as well, and you cannot perform all those on your mobile phones. Also, if you don't have your laptop or PC right now, then you can just attend this meeting and understand what's happening, and then you can do the same process later on your laptop when you get on.
Excuse me, ma'am. We just have to keep doing next, right? We don't have to select any options now for the Git, like while installing. Like no, just next, next, next.
Just to the yes.
Sorry.
And for the Nature's Club interview, it will be happening after the 12.
Excuse me, ma'am.
For the Nature's Club interview, it will be happening after 12. Okay. Then we don't need to worry.
I have downloaded the GitHub. What am I supposed to do next? Like, I have finished the thing, like, as you said.
Yes, finish. You have to install it and then you have to finish it. And then you have to sign up in GitHub. You have to sign up in GitHub. And
like, what I installed right now, just like, do I have to open that one or something?
What?
Like, installed Git right now. So, as I said, download Git. So, I did that, but. So am I supposed to open Git or something? What I'm supposed to do next?
You do not have to open that Git.
Okay.
We will be doing that. But before that, just sign up in the GitHub website. And you can use any of your email. Just remember the password. Okay.
Right, right.
Ma'am, I am facing problem in making username.
In the GitHub?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. You can't create the username which is already there. So you have to choose a different one, as it also happens in the Instagram and other.
Right now, can we use our college mail, right? Like, so that if any problem comes later on, so we can use our personal mail later on as well. So right now we can use the college mail.
It's your wish. If you want to use your college email, you can use that. If you do not want to use college email, you can, because it's not related to that. So.
No, no, I'm asking, like, can we make another account, right, as well with another Gmail account later on in Git? Like,
yes,
suppose
yes.
We want to just try this out, so I can use my college mail and later on use my personal mail for another account.
Yes. Those who have raised their hand, please tell the errors so we could move faster.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I have the GitHub desktop. Can I open it also, or should go through the web page only?
Basically, GitHub desktop is used further when you know a little about the Git, because that is easier than Git, but Git aana bhi zaruri hai. So first install the Git and sign up in the GitHub. Then I will also tell you about the GitHub desktop.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, in the finishing complete the Git setup wizard, mein, I have view release notes or launch Git Bash. Which should I select? Which should I
just select on the finish? The Git is installed, and now sign up in the GitHub. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Others, please tell the doubt, and those who have not installed yet, it's very very it takes very less time. Just download the Git from the Google, just click on that, and you have to select the default options.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what specific features usme kya select karna?
Please send the screenshot where you are selecting those features.
Ma'am, this one, collaborative coding automation.
Ma'am, how many members can we choose, student or just me? What do we have to choose? Like, how many team members will you be working with?
You are installing the Git.
I have installed the Git. I'm making the account on GitHub. So it is asking me how many team members will be working with you.
On welcome window, ma'am.
Yes, yes. While making the account, I have made the account. It is asking me.
Yes, you can go with just me.
You can skip that. You can go with the skip button. You can skip that. Yes.
I'm actually not having the skip button.
Ma'am, there is a
skip. Okay, yeah, it is there. Yeah, I found it.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Okay.
Ma'am, the Git Gucci GUI, it's there. It's great saying that you want to create a new repository, or the two options are also there. Which should I select?
Please send a screenshot.
Ma'am, I've made the account, ma'am. What next? Like on GitHub, I'm ready with the account.
Operating with the desktop, I can share you the from with my.
Ma'am, camera. I've made the account. Like what am I supposed to do next?
Please wait. Making the created an account.
Right, sure. Okay.
Ma'am?
Yes.
It's asking this.
Nikhilesh, instead of turning on your camera, you can just send a photo of your screen.
Yes, that would be good.
Yes, sir.
Do we have to select GitHub student benefits?
We'll tell you about GitHub student spec later. Now you don't have to select anything like that.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, in select components in GitHub's setup, what we have to do? Just next or we have to select something?
Where?
In Git setup.
You don't have to select anything. Just keep clicking on next and go with the recommended section.
Okay, thank you, sir.
All those who are done with installation of Git and have created their account on GitHub, please raise your hands so that we can continue. And if anyone is facing some other issue, you can just put a screenshot in the chat box.
Sir, in whole Git setup, we have to just click on next, next, and next only, right?
Yes.
Excuse me, sir.
Do we have to use a personal email or the email?
You can use any email. It won't create any difference. You are just creating a normal account.
Sir, I'm having some storage issues, so I cannot right now install Git, but have created an account at GitHub. Is that fine?
No, both are important for this today's session. So what you can do, you can delete. Yes,
Tamashi, you can continue.
Okay, so you will be skipping that part, most important part. So what you can do, you can delete those files which are not needed. And you have to do this fast because now we will be moving ahead. And I hope many of you have downloaded and installed the Git and also sign up in the GitHub. Those who have not done this, please send the screenshot, whatever error you are getting. We will be solving those in this chat. Okay.
Ma'am, how many members should we select on GitHub?
Please ask your questions one by one. Nikhil, you have opened GitHub GUI. You don't have to open it. So you can just click on quit. And Dipesh, you just have to click on, you just have to keep on clicking on next in the installation process.
Okay, sir.
Sir, I should quit.
Yes, you can quit the GUI. We are not going to use GUI. And that is something else.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, my email verification is not done in the GitHub.
You can verify
but my account email, is like.
If you open your email email inbox, then you can see a link over there, and you can verify your email from there. They must have sent a link on your mail.
Yes, sir. There is a code, but how to?
So you are saying that you have created your account, but you have not verified your email. You can go to github.com and try logging in, okay? Using the same account, signing in. And when you are signing in, if you have not verified your email, then they'll probably ask you to verify it. So you can verify it again, okay?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, on GitHub, it is asking how many members will be working. So, 50 plus.
You can skip. See, you can skip this. This is just for personalization. Personalization, and it won't affect your GitHub or any other process. And you can use your AIT mail or your personal mail as well. Okay.
Sir, what we have to choose in? What specific feature are you interested in?
Can you please share the screenshot of your screen? Because I think it is also a part of personalization, and you can skip that.
Sir, do we have to launch Git Bash in the last of the finish?
No, you don't have to launch Git Bash. You can just click on finish. And after clicking on finish, a tab will open in your browser, and you can also close that tab.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I can see only 45 of you have raised their hands. What about others? If you are facing any problems, please speak up.
Sir, we have to raise our hand if we have completed both Git and GitHub.
Yes, if you have completed the installation of Git and you have created an account on your on GitHub, then you can raise your hand.
Okay, sir.
And do it fast because we have to move ahead. So I think you all have not all most of you have done with the installation part, and now it's time to
yes,
use
ma'am.
That Git. Okay, so open your Git. You can open it in anywhere, just like I'm actually doing that. You can also see the screen, and you have to run these commands. Okay, so first of all, I will paste this command in the chat.
And we have to open the Git which we downloaded right now. So you download from the web, exe file.
Yes, you have to open that exe file. You have to install that exe file.
Yes, I meant to say that one only. I have installed it.
Abhishek Kumar, the screenshot you have shared is also a part of personalization process. If there is a skip button, you can skip it. And if there is no skip button, then you can select whatever you are interested in. It won't affect anything related to Git or what we are about to.
Sir, we have to open Bash, no? Git Bash.
You don't have to open anything now. For now, you just have to install Git, and you have to.
No, ma'am said no open Git. So actually, ma'am said no open Git.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I have installed Git, but sir, they are showing three applications: Git GUI, Git CMD,
yes.
And Git Bash. So what to open, sir?
You don't have to see. First, you have to create a folder, or you can also right-click on your desktop, and then you have to open Git Bash. Kamakshi, you have started with the Git Bash part, right?
Yes, I have started, sir. Yes, sir. I'm starting with the Git Bash part.
Okay. Then you can continue from there.
Okay, sir. So just go anywhere in the folder, right-click. And you will get two options now because you have installed the Git. So one is your Git GUI here, and other one is Git Bash here. You have to open the Git Bash, okay? So click on the Git Bash. You will see this type of window opening here. Now here, you have to write the username, whatever you have created in the GitHub, okay? So for that, you have to write a command, which is git config hyphen hyphen global user dot name, and in this you have to write your username which you have which you have just now created in the GitHub, okay?
Ma'am, could you please repeat, ma'am?
Yes, just open, just go anywhere in the folder, right click there, you will see two options, click on Git Bash here, and the window will open, which is Git Bash, and here you have to...
Ma'am?
Yes? Yes?
मेरा जो Git Bash है वो डेस्कटॉप पे है, तो उस पे डायरेक्ट क्लिक कर दो तो सही है ना? Git Bash में नहीं, डेस्कटॉप पे ऐड कर दिया ना आइकन पे.
हाँ हाँ चलेगा.
हाँ ओके ओके.
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम.
यस
मैम, आफ्टर दैट ब्लू स्क्रीन व्हिच वाज कमिंग ऑन द ब्राउजर लाइक दिस इंट्रोडक्शन नोन इश्यूज लाइसेंस एंड ऑल, आफ्टर दैट वी हैव टू डायरेक्टली क्लिक फॉर लाइक ओपनिंग द फोल्डर एंड क्लिक for Git Bash or GitHub, I mean Git Bash.
Akriti, you have created your ID on GitHub, right?
Yes, so I'm having your ID.
Yes, then you can directly go to your desktop and right click and then select Git Bash from there.
Okay.
So, okay. So this is your GitHub profile. Those who don't know, know. Yes.
Bitbucket is better on GitHub. Bitbucket is better on GitHub.
Okay, both have different GitHub and GitHub and Bitbucket both have their own advantages and disadvantages. Basically, GitHub doesn't pay much. In GitHub you have to pay for some facilities that you do not have to pay in the Bitbucket. So in that case, we will prefer Bitbucket. But the paid option of GitHub is good. So it is actually. Depends on us that what we want to choose, how many functions we want. So it's like that. Both are similar. So it's about that how you use, means if you have used that, then all you can tell that, okay, which one is better, which one is not better. Okay. So those who have created the GitHub account, then you can see this username. Here it is your username. And
excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Now, what was the command that we had to type in Git Bash?
You have to write git config hyphen hyphen global. Global is basically that whenever you create a repository, for now you just know whenever you make your project, then for that project your username should be that should be from your username. So all those projects. सारे के सारे प्रोजेक्ट्स के लिए यू यूज ग्लोबल. इफ यू डू नॉट वांट टू यूज ग्लोबल सिर्फ एक प्रोजेक्ट्स के लिए, देन यू डू नॉट राइट ग्लोबल. ओके, सो यू राइट गेट कॉन्फिग हाइफन हाइफन ग्लोबल यूजर डॉट नेम एंड हियर यू राइट योर यूजर नेम व्हिच इज रिटन इन द कॉर्नर ऑफ योर गेटअप अकाउंट. ओके,
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम.
यस
ma'am, please repeat.
How can we access Git on MacBook?
Git on MacBook?
Yes, ma'am. I've already installed it, but how can we like open it?
You have installed the Git on your MacBook, right?
Yes, sir.
Git Bash. And okay, then you can directly go search for Git Bash from your like search option, and then you can directly open Git Bash from there as well.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So I think I hope that all you have written the first command, git config global username.
Ma'am, I am getting a very big file after writing that command, config file location global use global config file and. Action get all get rich xp something like this.
Please send the screenshot.
Ma'am, do we have to run the command? Do we have to run the command?
You just have to write the command and press enter.
Ma'am, can you repeat the command again?
What?
We have pasted command in the chat box. Please get copy it from there.
Okay.
I'm pasting a similar command that I have written. Okay. You do not have to write this. You instead of this, you have to write your username.
Sir, I have shared the photo in the group of what I'm getting after typing the command.
I cannot see any new photo in chat box.
Yes. Okay, I'll send it again.
Good. Others, you, those who have installed the Git have written the first command and
yes, ma'am. Other,
okay.
We are not getting anything new.
Yes, there will be nothing new. It's similar that is coming in on my screen. The next command is your email, whatever email you have put, you have by which we have created your account. So git config global user.email and then you write your email. Okay, the similar command.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, the when you we write username, is it case sensitive or not?
Yes, your username is case sensitive.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, what are we supposed to get after we type the command?
You do not get anything new. It's similar that does. It's similar as it is coming on my screen.
Ma'am, I'm getting config file location. I have shared this introduction type, other something like this. I don't understand. What is that? Shared the screenshot. Yes, ma'am. Is it this one? One shot, sir.
You have write the user.name. You have used this. You have to write global also. Git config global, then user.name. You have missed the global.
Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, if we use the same email as we used to create the GitHub account, would it automatically link these two accounts?
Yes, yes.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Any other problem?
And what after the username? Same for the email also.
Yes, you have to write this command. Email.
Okay, I'm user.email.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I'm getting command not found.
You have written the wrong command. That's why it's maybe.
Please share the screenshot in the chat box.
Yes, sir.
All those who are saying.
Right.
See, you have not.
Sir, it's saying fatal not in Git directory. Fatal not in Git directory.
Yes.
Please share screenshots. And who is this? I cannot see your name here, but you have not given the space between config and global. Please copy the commands which are directly available in chat box if you are facing some issues. There is a space between config and global, okay?
Sir, it is not pasting directly command in Git bash.
You can right click and then paste.
So after ma'am, email also it will remain the same.
Yes.
Please one by one.
Yeah.
Ma'am, when we are signing up for GitHub, then their question comes, how many team members will be working with you? Just, so what we have to click on it.
Just skip that part. No,
I've shared a screenshot.
Okay, ma'am.
See all those. Yes, continue.
Sir, after like we have typed this git config global username and our name, after that we have to write for that email one which ma'am has shared right now.
No, first you have done the username one, no? Yes, then you can continue with the user email and okay. You have to give your email.
Okay, sir.
Sir, after writing git config email, it will remain same again.
Sorry, can you please repeat your question?
So after when we will write the git config email, it will remain same again or any change will there?
No, there will be no change. It will just, it will not show any other changes, okay? It will just accept your code. See,
sir, please see Abhay Sahu, what I have said.
Yes, Abhay Sahu, you have given space between those dash and global. There is no space between dash and global.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, can we log in with any other ID than the email ID of our college?
Yes.
You can use any email ID for creating your account on GitHub. And when you are here in this GUI, you have to use the same ID which you have used for creating your account.
So how many of you are done with these two parts, that is username and email?
Done, ma'am.
Done, ma'am.
Done, ma'am.
Done, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, done.
Yes, ma'am, completed.
If you are done and you want to check that you have performed everything correctly, you can just go in the same terminal and write git space config space user.name. When you write this command and press enter, your username will be shown on next line, and similarly you can do the same for user email, and your user email will be shown on the next line. So if you have performed everything correctly, then you can see your username and your user email. See?
It will be something like this. If you have done that correctly, then you will get your username when you write this command, and you will get your email when you write the git config user.email. So those we have done with the part can check that they have did the correctly or not. And those who are not done with their part, please do it fast.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, please show the please again.
What?
Please show it again. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am, done.
All those who are asking, is this correct? You can just use the commands which I just told you and check if it is showing your username and your user email to verify if you have performed everything correctly. Okay.
Yes, sir. It's showing.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, it is replying me nothing. It is showing nothing. It is. I'm just taking the command and replying nothing, sir. I'm just typing git config user.name. But previously it has accepted. I don't know.
Can
is it not
please share the screenshot?
Yes, sir, just an L-shot.
You can see my screen. It will be something like that. When you will write this git config user.name, you will get your username, GitHub username.
How to edit what?
Ma'am, it is showing username, but not showing user email.
Sir,
git config. So you have not done this second command properly.
Sir, actually, I have not used the double inverted commas in the first username one, so that's why it's not showing the user one username one correctly. So how to edit it now?
No, you can use the you can just type in the first command again, git config space dash dash global space user dot name, and then you can write your username and close in quotations. Also, you can also skip the quotations in case of email, but you have to use the double inverted quotes in case of your username.
Okay, sir.
Sir, I've sent the photo, sir. I've sent the photo.
Sir, I'm done with it. How can I check it if it's right or wrong? Please tell me.
Yes, you can just write git space config space user.name, and it will show your username on next line. Similarly, you can do the same for your user.email, and it will show the user email on your next line.
Hello, okay, hello, sir. I've sent the photo, sir. One shot, sir.
I can see photo of the panther.
Sir, what? It is above, sir. One shot.
I am also issue.
See, if you are asking me to check if you have performed it correctly, you can just use those commands.
Sir, I have sent use the command, but it is not showing any username. It is just taking the command as it is. It is not showing anything in next line. Yes.
I am facing the same issue as well.
Yes, sir. Send the photo.
Okay, those who have installed the Git and not yet done with the part, please raise your hand. And who are done can down their hands. Means those who have installed the Git properly and now they are not done with these two commands. They are facing difficulties. And others can down their hands.
once you have used wrong command, see, git config, then you have to use dash dash global. Okay, then you have done it on the next user. You have not given space after user dot name once.
Yes.
That is why it is not showing your username.
Okay, so after yes, user dot name, I have to give a space.
Yes, yes, you have to give a space, and then it will show your username.
Ma'am, can you share your git screen?
Sure.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I wrote my user email wrong. Can I edit it?
Yes, you can. Means you have not written you that can... email. Yes, sir.
Yes, you just have to type the command again, and then that will edit your username.
Yes, sir. Now I'm getting the username, sir. Now.
Ma'am, I forgot to close the inverted comma, and it so after an enter it showing nothing.
Write that again, command.
Ma'am, I'm not getting email command done because it is showing it is not in the directory.
Please.
Send a screenshot.
Ma'am, please share the screen. Ma'am, of Git.
Okay.
Yes, Aditi, this is correct.
What to do next?
All those who are done, please just wait for some more time. Let others complete. Okay, yes, Prabha, just a second. Is this the same email as the one you have used for registering on GitHub?
Yes, sir.
Just a second.
All those who have not done with this with these two commands, please tell your errors, because you will be left out then.
Rajul Kumar, you have written the wrong command. You can see the command on screen. It is not git config. It is git config. So please write commands properly.
Ma'am, is there a space between name and username?
Yes, there is a space after username.
Okay, sir.
Sir?
Yes.
I'm Dipankar. Kindly resolve my issue, please. I have sent you the photo.
Yes, Dipank. I think it is working properly, Dipankar. What is your issue?
I'm not getting back username and email.
Yes, because you have written dot dot global there. You don't have to write global there. It's just git space config space user dot name. Please.
Sir, in future, if you make another account, we can log in through that one as well, right? No?
Yes, you can like write out. Later on. Dipankar, commands are also shown on the screen. Shared by Kamachi. You can you can check your commands from there. You have written wrong command.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes. Sir. Excuse me, sir.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, it's not showing my email ID. There's an error not in Git directory.
Just a second. Other than the not in error.
Sir, what is the next command?
If you are done, please wait and. Because of that surface.
Sir, what do you have to do after writing mail in Git?
You have configured your username and your user email, right?
Yes, sir.
Then you just have to wait.
Pardon me.
Sir? Sir, do we have to type this config global list?
If you type git config global list, then you will see all the configuration about your system. You can type in that command. You can try and type in that command and see what is showing on this page. But we have already configured your username.
Sir, can we extend this class?
Sorry. Can you please repeat what?
Sir, we can extend this class from 12 to 1.
Why do you want to extend this class? I don't get it.
Because we had not learned anything yet.
Who is this? Can you please, just a second. Who is this? Can you please tell me your name?
Sir, Nikhil Kumar, sir.
Okay, Nikhil. Yes, we have targets for the class and we'll complete that in the given time, or we'll extend the class if we feel like that. So you don't have to worry about that. Someone was asking something.
So they're showing an error not in a git directory.
Yes, just a second. I'm just checking that error.
Others, those who have not done with this, these two commands, please make it fast.
Ma'am, actually, I'm not getting my username after writing git conf user.name.
Can you paste the command which that you are writing there?
Ma'am, I will give the screenshot of.
All those who are facing not a git directory, for now just write git space init there and try the commands again. Git space init. I've pasted the command in the chat box. Also, those who are done, please lower your hands and only those who have issues.
Your email, you have not added the email successfully. See, there was an error, fatal. So please write that command again. Git config --, global user.email. This one. You have to write it again because that is not run.
Okay.
See, if you are facing this problem, fatal not a git directory, then please try writing the command again. And if it still doesn't work, then try writing git space init, a command which I have just pasted in the chat box. Please write this command and then try write again. It should work.
And one thing more, these are the two hyphens, so please use them carefully, because the error can be also from these two hyphens.
All those who are done, please lower your hands, and only the guys who are facing problems, keep your raise your hand.
You can also run the command git config hyphen hyphen global hyphen hyphen list, and you will get the your username and your user user email in the one command. So those who are done can run this command.
Nirmal Kumar, are you facing any problems?
Which one, ma'am?
Git config hyphen hyphen global hyphen hyphen list.
Ma'am, the filters are not showing in the list or list command.
Share a screenshot if you are still facing some.
Sir, the username and username and email is shown, but the filter are not.
Your username and email is there, right? You don't have to after yes, git config list. You are saying it after doing git config global list. You are only saying your username and then user email, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you don't have to worry about other things. You only need those for configuration.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I'm not able to configure my email, sir. It is showing fatal error.
Yes.
So this is perfect.
Can you please try the git space init command first and then repeat it again?
Okay.
Nitin Kumar, are you still facing any issues? 3134. If you are not facing issues, then you can lower your hands. Achal Kumari, Akshat, Sunil Chaudhary, B. Bhavani, all those who are not facing any issues, please lower your hands.
Those who are facing issues, please raise the hands. So it will be easier for us.
Have to raise our hands, right?
If you are facing issues, then you can raise your hands, otherwise lower your hands.
And please send the screenshot and your issues in the chat box.
Haan bhai hai par main abhi to
Hello sir, this is Professor. I have sent my screenshot having an error.
Sorry, who is this?
Sir, this is Prakar. I have sent my screenshot in the chat box.
Prakar, did you try git init command, which I just told you?
Yes, sir, I tried.
Can you please screen your share your screenshot again with the git init command?
Okay.
Rijil Kumar, I think you have configured it properly. If you want to see your username and user email, you can just try git space config space user.
I think there should not be space.
This is someone space. Else, I guess.
Okay. Others, please do it fast. Whatever error you are getting, please send us screenshots.
Nikita, but you have configured everything, right? I think it is correct. You don't have to worry about
yes,
master.
Sir.
Okay, sir.
Yes, then this is Dipesh Tiwari. This is correct. Prakar, where is your screenshot? I cannot see. Okay.
Dipankar, what's the problem?
Hello.
Yes, Dipankar, what's the problem?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
I'm not having any issues.
So why you are raising hands?
Hello.
Okay, okay.
Yes, you can ask.
Yes.
हेलो मैम.
यस यस
मैम. उसके बाद क्या करना है मैम? यूजर नेम लिख दिया, ईमेल लिख दिया, उसके बाद
जस्ट चेक दैट वेदर यू हैव रन द कमांड्स करेक्टली और नॉट. यू जस्ट हैव टू राइट गेट कॉन्फिग यूजर डॉट नेम एंड देन गेट कॉन्फिग यूजर डॉट ईमेल. यू विल गेट द आउटपुट लाइक दिस. एंड इफ यू डू नॉट वांट टू राइट दैट, यू कैन राइट गेट कॉन्फिग हाइफन हाइफन ग्लोबल स्पेस हाइफन हाइफन लिस्ट.
Prakhar, do one thing. Close this and then go to your desktop and right click there, and then try both commands again. It should work.
Okay, sir.
Close this Git Bash and then go to your desktop, right click there, then to Git Bash here, and after that run those two commands again.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Is there anyone else who is still facing any issues? Arshil Kumari, Sunil Chaudhary, B. Bhavani, Ankita Mishra, Shaurya Nekpal. Please lower your hands if you are not facing any issues.
So let's move further. Those who are having issues, please send in the chat box. Okay. So we have learned about the Git. Actually, we did a little bit. We also write commands in the Git. Now it's time to know about something about the GitHub. So Git is basically in your local, but GitHub is a hosted service. Okay. So GitHub is a web-based interface. You use it writing the commands in your Git. So that's why we are connecting the Git and GitHub. So basically, Git it is a social media of the development. So as you do in your Instagram and Facebook, you also similar things you do in the GitHub also. You write your codes and you post your codes. Okay, something like that. In Instagram you post your pics, in the GitHub you write projects, you make team and then also make projects, and then what you do, you make those projects global so anyone else can access those projects. So after that we have connected a Git with a GitHub account. Now we are going to make repositories and other things so that we can now use the GitHub. So before that, I want to tell you the steps and what are the terms which we should know. So first, the term that I am using here is a repository. So basically, a repository is something like your the upper layer, the project in which you will be putting your code from your local. Means what you will be doing, you will be writing code in your local, in your PCs, wherever you want, in the text files and others. Then you will upload that whole folder to the GitHub. Okay, how? By using the commands in the Git. So by using the commands in the Git, you will upload that folder. It's something like, not, we do not use upload word in Git, we use push and pull. So starting with the repository, so you will push that, you will upload that folder in the GitHub, and that will be your repository. So basically, first of all, you have to make the repository. Okay, it's something like the folder in the GitHub where you can put all your codes. And repository is not one, it is something like your name of the project, in which project you are working. So the first step that comes is to initialize the repository. Make a workspace where you will where you will put your projects, right? Then second step is in the GitHub is set your team. As you're working in a project, you need a team. And so for that, you can connect different GitHub accounts and make a team, and then you can start committing. Okay, so what is committing? Basically, whenever there are changes, what we do, we commit those changes. Like I have make a workspace, a repository, and in that repository, I have made one page. I have made a website. I have made the first page of the website. I had pushed that code. Push that code means I have uploaded that code to GitHub by using the commands in the Git. We will be using those commands in Git now. Okay, so I have to push. So I'm using upload word here, but the correct is push and pull. So I have want to upload the code of first page to the GitHub using the Git by the commands. So that is how I will do that. I will first of all stage those changes. I will I will name the changes whichever I had made. I will write I will write that first page created, and then I will upload that. Okay, and the next is branches, pull request, and this we will cover this further. Let's cover these steps now. So the next step is creating a repository in GitHub. Repository is something like workspace. हमने वेबसाइट बनाई है तो उस वेबसाइट को कहाँ रखें? तो उसके लिए हम एक रिपोजिटरी बनाते हैं कि ओके वी आर पुटिंग ऑल द कोड इन दिस रिपोजिटरी. सो जस्ट व्हाट यू हैव टू गो, यू जस्ट हैव टू गो इनटू योर गिटहब अकाउंट एंड हियर यू कैन सी दिस. दिस इज समथिंग लाइक your GitHub account. Okay, so here you can see, so these are the repositories in which I have made, and also here the repository in which I have worked, and you can also add the repositories. Repository is something like project. In projects pe maine kaam kiya hai, theek hai, ya in projects ye dusron ke yahan pe wo projects bhi hote hain, those I have taken from the other. Tum you can access the projects which are public. जो प्रोजेक्ट्स पब्लिक होते हैं तुम उसको किसी के गिटहब अकाउंट से ले भी सकते हो. सो बेसिकली और फिर अपने यहाँ ऐड कर सकते हो, तो यहाँ वो सारे प्रोजेक्ट्स शो हो जाते हैं, राइट? सो हाउ यू कैन मेक दैट, जस्ट गो क्लिक ऑन दिस प्लस बटन. प्लीज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू गो टू योर गिटहब अकाउंट इफ यू हैव मेड दैट साइन इन देयर एंड गो टू दिस प्लस बटन, क्लिक ऑन न्यू रिपोजिट्री. You will see the page like this. Create a new repository. Here you are the owner of that repository. You are the project owner. Tum project bana rahe ho, right? Write the name of the repository. Suppose you are making a website or any other project. So uske according isko name kar sakte hain. So as I'm doing, means it is also related to coding. So jo coding karte hain, they can also write coding here, right?
Excuse me.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Ma'am, can we open this through GitHub desktop, because it will be easy for us.
Why you want to use GitHub desktop now?
Because my ID is already logged in that, so that's why.
So just go to the Google and sign in the GitHub and made repository here.
Okay.
Yes, GitHub desktop is a different thing, and we'll tell you when you can use GitHub desktop or how you should use GitHub desktop. But first, you should focus on learning the command lines. So please follow what is being taught here.
Okay. So suppose hum ek project bana rahe and we are making a school, ek school ke ID website bana rahe. So you can just write here your the name that you want to give, school, and it is also something like those repository. You have to use only those repository name which are available. So I write school web. Okay, in description it is optional if you want to give a description. Okay, this is a website for a school, you can write. So this is optional. Then there is an option of public and private. Okay, so there are many projects which we do not want to show everyone. So we put those projects in the private. Okay, because जो बड़ी बड़ी companies होती हैं, they do not वो अपने projects को बेचती हैं, they sell their projects, and if they will make the public, that it will be difficult for them. So basically GitHub हमारे लिए free क्यों है, ऐसा क्यों है GitHub हमारे लिए free है? GitHub is not totally free. So वो कंपनियाँ अपने projects को private करती हैं and they work in their project, private project. But you can't work, तुम नहीं वर्क कर सकते until and unless you pay. So working in a private project, you have to get that paid option of the GitHub. So for now, I'm making a public repository, means it is accessible for all. The next is your add a readme file at git.git.ignore. So basically readme file is a text file in which you write that how the project what the project you have made, how any other those installed those copy that project can use it. Then the second is add, basically these are the test files. If you will take here that you have to write the text file will be added to your project. So for now I do not need this. I just write this repository name, description, public, and then create a repository. Okay, so this is the first page that you will get, and here all the commands are written already. You just have to simply paste this command, but carefully. Okay, so this is a
yes. Ma'am, after the school web thing, I got disconnected. Could you tell what do we have to do after that? School web, any type school web after that?
You have to fill the options which are present there.
Ma'am, public, just, I have done public, then it is saying add a readme file, add gitnore, or choose a license.
I just filled the repository name, description, public, and just below that create repository. Okay?
Ma'am, create. Yes, I just created the repository.
Okay, so after this you will get this type of page in which all the commands are already written. Now ab kya hua hai, your workspace has been created. Now what you have to do, you have to write the code in your local PC and then you have to upload that code in that repository. Okay, so maine wo school ka website banane ke liye, what I will do, ये बेसिकली कोड कहाँ बनते हैं, कोड हमारे लोकल में कहीं फोल्डर्स में बनते हैं. सो आई विल मेक अ फोल्डर, सो न्यू फोल्डर, यू कैन ऑल डू विद मी, आई एम ऑल्सो टेलिंग हियर, सिंपल सिंपल थिंग्स हैं. सो यू हैव टू मेक अ न्यू फोल्डर, यू कैन नेम एनीथिंग. सो वेबसाइट जैसे बनती है, ठीक है, बनती है. सो वी विल राइट हियर वेबसाइट, स्कूल वेबसाइट और एनीथिंग. Now inside this websites में क्या होता है कि अंदर different different text files, HTML files होती, CSS files होती, and you have to make the files here, right? So here, click on the new.
Your voice. Can you please repeat?
I just made a repository here. Okay. After that, I leave here. And then I go to this, I created a new folder and I named that folder according that I want. Okay, then in that folder now I am adding any file. Yes, hello,
I think someone else, I can also on that is creating a disturb.
What's the problem? Can you repeat? Hello?
Ma'am, what is the problem with the repository?
What you? Write it in the chat box. Yes?
Please write your question in chat box. We are not able to hear your question.
See, I didn't simple things. I just made the repository. How I made the repository, I go into my GitHub page, sign in, and then plus button. In that, I create a new repository. I fill the repository name, public description, then create new repository, and then this is the page that I was getting here. After that, I'm making the folder in my local. So this was the folder that I made school website. Here I'm making a new text file, text document, and in which I am writing the code. So whatever the jaise bhi code likha jata hai, you can write the code here. So I'm just writing okay.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am? Sir, I just lost the connection. I was there when
your connection is still not good. You can write the doubt in the chat box.
Dipesh, your
After making the school website folder, we have to make a notepad file in the school website folder.
Yes, inside that folder. If you want, you can rename also that. So see, I have made this in my local. Now, assume that this is a code which is written inside this, and now I want that that this code should be there in the GitHub. So anyone else which is working with me can access the code with whatever I have written. So what I will do, everyone had made this folder, and inside this a text file. If yes, then we can go ahead.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So basically,
ma'am, what do we have to write in the notepad?
You can write anything. Anything you want. You want to upload in your GitHub repository.
Ma'am. Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I just lost the connection. I was there in a create a new repository.
Create a new repository. You have created the repository. Have you created the repository?
No, ma'am, no, ma'am.
And we have to select add a readme file or not?
You do not have to select a readme file. You just have to fill the repository name and you have to click on the public and just create the repository.
After writing anything in the text document, we have to save it or just end?
You have to save it. Otherwise, it will get lost. Means if it will not save in my local, then how you can send to the website, okay?
Rather make your repository public.
Yes, make your repository public.
Ma'am, what should we write in repository name? Anything.
Anything you want. After making the repository, create a folder in the local, and after that, add a text file or anything that you want to upload in that repository. So basically, हम क्या कर रहे हैं? उस repository में हम अपने local में जो हमने folder बनाए हैं, वो भेजेंगे अभी. So please make it fast so I could move ahead.
Ma'am, how can we make text file in Mac?
Yes, text file in.
Ma'am, how can we MacBook? Like there is no notepad in there.
Make any file, .html file or other files that is comfortable. Yeah.
Ma'am, your laptop battery seems to be lapsing. Might end up soon.
Please connect the laptops to the charger. We will be ending soon, so stay connected. So I think most of you are done with this part.
Ma'am, he's talking yes. about your computer.
Yeah. Sorry.
Ma'am, what is next after saving text document?
What?
After saving the text document.
After saving the text document. Okay, I'm telling that. I think all of you have done with that.
Yes, ma'am.
So, let's move ahead. So, after saving this text document, what we are doing in the inside this folder, we are I will open this git bash. So abhi jahan bhi hai ye git bash usko close kar do, isko folder ke andar hi open karna. You have to open the git bash inside the folder that you have created, where you can see the text document or whichever document you have made. Okay, so right click there and git bash here. In case you are not able to see that whether you have right or wrong, just see the upper line which is written. Is it the same is it the same name which is the name of your folder? That is a school website. So it is written here, school website. This means that I am inside the school website folder, right? So now
you
have to write
that, please.
Yes,
very sorry.
Okay, you have to whatever folder you have made, you have to go inside that, and then you have to right click there, and then click on the git bash here.
I'm on the notepad file, right? On the notepad file.
Not on the notepad file. You have
in
to click
folder.
Anywhere. Yes, inside the folder.
Open, ma'am.
Open. So if you have opened the git bash, then wherever you have made your repository, go to that tab. Here you can see these commands, right? Now you just have to copy paste these commands one by one. You can do this with me also, because it is very important, and I will explain the command what is the meaning of the command one by one. So first command is your git init. So this is something like that, you are uploading this folder to the GitHub website. So this will not upload by itself. You have to do something. You have to create something here which will look after this folder, because after this, it will also track that what is changing in this folder. So what you will do, you will write git init. So by doing this, there will be a git init, a git folder that will be created here. So just write git init. So see, empty git repository, the repository which we have, empty git repository have created here. A folder has created that will look after the files which are changing here. So first command, write git init. It will initialize a repository here. Basically, it will be not visible in your PCs, because I have changed some settings. So in the hidden items, if you will click on the hidden items in the view option, you can see that git file folder, right? And
excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, can you please explain the GitHub part again? Like, what do we have to do in the GitHub? Like, we have to upload this folder there.
Yes. See, website, you are making a website. So you will make the website in your PC, in your local, and now you have to upload that in the GitHub. So one simple way was that was already told, that you can create you can made a whole website and then upload that whole in the Google Drive, right? So in that case, you can't track the files. That agar tumne koi file change kiya, tum fir se usko upload karoge. But in this case, what is happening, hum yahan pe agar koi file change karenge, and then also hum usi cheez mein upload wahi pe upload karenge, aur wo change wali file jayegi. सो और वो दो लाइन चेंज किए तो वो दो लाइन ही चेंज होके जाएंगी, द होल फोल्डर विल नॉट गेट अपलोडेड इन द गिटहब. ओके, सो दिस इज समथिंग.
एक्सप्लेन द प्रोसेस अगेन, द हाउ डिड आई, हाउ डू आई अपलोड इट टू गिटहब,
हाउ डू आई. ओके, वी आर नाउ अपलोडिंग इन द ऑन द गिटहब. यस
मैम, कैन यू जस्ट रिवाइज द होल प्रोसेस बिकॉज़ इट्स क्रिएटिंग अ मोर कंफ्यूजन.
यस मैम,
यस मैम, प्लीज.
यस मैम.
Yes. See, we have a Git. We have a GitHub. Git is simpler command prompt like the window in your local. GitHub is a website. Okay. Now, what we are doing? Suppose we are making a project. Now, if you are making a project, we will make that project in a local. How? You will just create a folder, right? Those who know coding, they also made project. So, just we will. Make a folder and inside that we will create different files. If you are making the PPTs also, you create different PPTs means many PPTs. So something like that. Now this folder, you have this folder, and now as you are working with your team, tumne is folder mein kya kiya, you had made half of the project, okay, and other member want to access this project. So you have two ways, either you take your PC and you go to your friend and give him. Right, but if you both are far, what you will do? तुमने अभी तक क्या use किया? तुमने अभी तक सिर्फ एक folder बनाया, उसमें कुछ changes किए हैं. अब तुम चाहते हो कि तुम्हारा जो दोस्त है, उसको वो आधा code लिखना है, वो कैसे लिखेगा? So what you did? तुमने git का use करते हुए अपने local में तुमने git install किया and git में क्या किया? तुमने अपनी जो GitHub में website है. GitHub में वेबसाइट इज लाइक, वो GitHub अलग है, GitHub एक वेबसाइट है, git एक ऐसा कमांड है, कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट है टाइप है. सो तुम्हारा क्या हुआ है कि तुमने जो प्रोजेक्ट बनाया है, तुम्हें अपने दोस्त तक पहुंचाना है एंड ऐसे उसमें काम करना है कि तुम एक दूसरे की फाइल्स ट्रैक कर पाओ. सो इन दैट केस व्हाट यू डिड, तुमने अपने git में अपना GitHub का जो अकाउंट है वो लिंक किया ताकि तुम अपने दोस्त के साथ काम कर सको. सो आफ्टर दैट व्हाट यू डिड, अब तुम क्या करोगे, उस GitHub में, ये जो हमने GitHub अपना अकाउंट बनाया था, इसमें एक ऐसी स्पेस, वर्क स्पेस बना रहे हैं जहाँ हम काम कर सके. सो बेसिकली हमने क्या बोला कि सपोज मुझे स्कूल की वेबसाइट पे काम करना है, तो मैंने यहाँ एक रिपोजिटरी बना दी, स्कूल वेबसाइट. तो अगर मैंने यहाँ एक वेबसाइट बनाई, सॉरी, रिपोजिटरी बना दी, स्कूल वेबसाइट, तो अगर मैं उस रिपोजिटरी को खोलूंगी तो उस रिपोजिटरी के अंदर जो भी कोड लिखा होगा वो स्कूल वेबसाइट से रिलेटेड होगा, और यही सिमिलर कोड जो होगा वो मेरे जो पर्सन टू है, जो मेरे साथ काम कर रहा है, उसके पास भी होगा, क्योंकि वो भी उस रिपोजिटरी को एक्सेस कर पा रहा होगा, क्योंकि हम टीम में काम कर रहे होंगे. एंड अब उसको वो कोड देना है मुझे. अभी मैंने यहाँ पे रिपोजिटरी बनाई, मैंने उसको अंदर का कोड नहीं दिया है, तो वो कोड देने के लिए ही मैं क्या कर रही हूँ, आई एम यूजिंग द गिट, जिसमें से मैंने जो कोड जहाँ भी लिखा है, जैसे सपोज आई हैव रिटन द कोड इन दिस फोल्डर, तो यहाँ पे मैंने कोड लिखा है, तो मैं गिट का यूज करके मैं GitHub अकाउंट पे अपना कोड डाल रही हूँ. आई एम शिफ्टिंग द कोड फ्रॉम माई लोकल टू द वेबसाइट इन माई अकाउंट, GitHub अकाउंट. इज इट क्लियर?
यस मैम.
बेसिकली वेन यू विल डू दिस प्रोसेस अगेन एंड अगेन, वेन यू विल मेक मैनी रिपोजिटरीज, विल मेक द प्रोजेक्ट, सो इट विल बी मोर क्लियर फॉर यू. ओके, for now it's very different and new, so it seems to be very confusing for me also. It was first time very confusing.
Excuse me,
so ma'am. Yes,
like ma'am, by writing git init command we have just connected our text to the GitHub.
We have not just created the with the GitHub. By git init we have made a repository here that will look after the files which are present inside this folder. And okay, whatever changes are going on in this folder will be written on that git repository that is inside this folder. See, okay, there are two git repository. One is inside my this folder, which is on my in my local. The other one is in the website. And website, okay, and these are not linked now.
Okay.
They will be linked when I will write further commands.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So. Yes. मैंने यहाँ जो रिपोजिटरी बनाई है, लोकल में जो बनाई है यहाँ पे, उनको मैं अभी अपने GitHub अकाउंट से लिंक करूँगी. और वो लोकल में इसलिए बनाई है ताकि जो भी चेंजेस इसके अंदर हो रहे हैं मेरे फाइल्स में, वो उसमें आ सके. नहीं तो फिर ये तो सिंपल वही हो गया कि मैं अपनी फाइल्स को गूगल ड्राइव पे अपलोड कर दूँ, राइट?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So after this, see, मैंने एक यहाँ पे बना दिया है गिट रिपोजिटरी. नाउ मैंने जो भी यहाँ पे फाइल्स डाली हैं उनको मुझे क्या करना है, मुझे अपने अकाउंट में डालना है. तो उसके पहले मुझे इनको क्या करना पड़ेगा, स्टेज करना पड़ेगा, ऐड करना पड़ेगा. सो आई डिड गिट ऐड. इससे क्या हुआ, जितनी भी फाइल्स मैंने यहाँ बनाई हैं नई फाइल्स, वो मेरी जो रिपोजिटरी है वो ऐड हो गई है. और अब मैं उन्हें जब पोस्ट करूंगी या अपलोड कर सकती हूँ, मैं एक तरीके से अपलोड करने के लिए मैंने सेलेक्ट कर दिया है. गिट ऐड इज समथिंग लाइक यू आर सेलेक्टिंग द फाइल्स विच यू वांट टू अपलोड. तुम सिंपल यहाँ पे उस फाइल का नाम भी लिख सकते हो कि डू नॉट वांट टू अपलोड ऑल डॉट की जगह सपोज स्कूल डॉट टीएक्सटी लिख दो. सो ओनली दैट विल बी गिट अपलोडेड. सो गिट ऐड इज समथिंग लाइक यू आर सेलेक्टिंग द फाइल्स दैट यू वांट टू अपलोड इन द गिटहब, राइट. आफ्टर दैट वॉट यू विल नेम दिस चेंज यू हैव मेड. This is a commit. Commit is something like checkpoints. जैसे हमारे गेम में होता है कि यू आर एट अ फर्स्ट लेवल, सेकेंड लेवल, थर्ड लेवल, तो वो लेवल अलग अलग होते हैं. तो मैंने अभी स्कूल वन का जो टेक्स्ट फाइल डाला है उसमें क्या है, उसमें थोड़ा सा कोड लिखा है. तो मैं क्या बोलूँगी, what I will tell to my friend, okay, I have written the first three lines of my code. So, मैं कैसे बोलूँगी, आई कॉन्ट टेल हिम ऑन द फोन ओके आई हैव रिटन द फर्स्ट थ्री लाइन्स ओके. क्योंकि अगर मैं इस कोड को आगे फर्दर शेयर करूँगी तो क्या होगा, इसको जो लोग भी देखेंगे उनको कैसे पता चलेगा कि पहली तीन लाइनें कब लिखी गई हैं, कहाँ लिखी गई हैं. वी वॉन्ट टू चेंज इट. सो उनको ऐसे पता चलेगा जब वहाँ चेक पॉइंट्स बने होंगे. ओके, चेक पॉइंट बना हुआ है इस टाइम पे. ओके, फर्स्ट थ्री लाइन एडेड. तो तुम्हारी मर्जी है, तुम्हें जो भी इसमें देना है. सो मैंने इसमें हेलो वर्ड लिखा है. तो मैं क्या कमिट कर सकती हूँ, आई कैन राइट हेयर गिट कमिट वन लाइन एडेड. और या फिर बिकॉज फर्स्ट कमिट है, पहली बार कर रहे हो, तो फर्स्ट कमिट वट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू मेक. मैंने आधा कोड लिख लिया, आई कैन राइट हेयर हाफ कोड रिटन. सो इन केस अगर किसी को बहुत जाना हो कि आधा कोड जब, क्योंकि अगर गलती पकड़नी है तो वी हैव टू रिवर्स बैक, क्योंकि ये गलती आई कहाँ से है. तो उसके लिए हमें पता होना चाहिए, ओके व्हाट आर द हेडिंग्स, क्या हेडिंग्स से हमें आ रहा है. सो कमिट से हमें ये फ़ायदा होता है कि हमें जब रिवर्स बैक करना होता है, मान लो कि गलती हमारी पहले ही कोड से आई है, कि पहले का आधा कोड जो ही गलत था, ठीक है, तो हम क्या करेंगे, हम उस कमिट में जाएंगे जहाँ पे लिखा होगा कि जहाँ पे पहला आधा कोड आया है. सो दैट विल बी रिटन इन द कमिट कि ओके फर्स्ट हाफ कोड एडेड. यस
मैम, इसके जो आपने ये लिखा है डबल इनवर्टेड कॉमास में फर्स्ट कमिट,
यस,
ये इस कमांड का मतलब ये यही क्यों लिखा फर्स्ट कमिट, कुछ और क्यों नहीं लिखा, लाइक व्हाट इज दिस, इसका मीनिंग क्या है?
इसका मीनिंग ये है, व्हाटएवर चेंजेस यू आर मेकिंग इन योर फाइल, तुमने जो भी चेंजेस बनाए और तुम उनको अपलोड कर रहे हो, उनको तुम किस उनको तुम नाम दे रहे हो कि ओके मैंने ये चेंजेस बनाए हैं. एंड दिस शुड बी अ शॉर्ट नेम. मैंने यहाँ पे सिर्फ हेलो वर्ड लिखा है. So I can write here also hello world.
Okay.
Right. कुछ भी लिख सकते हो. Suppose मैंने website का header बना दिया. So I can write here that header. Right. Simple. Git commit -m header. So simple ये होता है कि इससे हमें पता चल जाता है okay इस time पे ये वाला add किया गया. Because अभी जब हम GitHub में इसको देखेंगे ना तो हमको दिखाएगा कि इस commit के नीचे ये वाला code जो है वो add किया गया है. So I press the enter. So see, this is master root commit hello world. One file changed. देखो बता रहे, एक file change हुई है, एक insertion किया है. इसे कैसे पता चला? ये जो get init किया था हमने, उससे पता चला कि हाँ हमने एक file add की थी जिसमें हमने एक insertion किया है, right? So ये कहाँ किया है? school1.txt में. So that GitHub repo that we made here by get init is look referring to these files that what is happening here, right? So after this command, what you can do, tumne can just go here. School one. Here you had done with the git init, git commit. Now this is basically a branch. Branch ऐसा होता है कि जब भी हम कोई चीज़ बनाते हैं तो क्या होता है कि वी डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू चेंज द मेन थिंग मीन्स वी हैव रिटन द कोड ऑफ अ वेबसाइट नाउ वी वॉन्ट दैट इसका जो मिडल वाला पार्ट है इसमें टेबल आना चाहिए था बट अभी के लिए नहीं आ रहा है सो वी डू नॉट वॉन्ट कि हाँ अभी आए हम पूरा पहले उसको बना के टेस्ट कर ले उसके बाद आए तो वट वी डू हम पूरा कोड को रखते हैं और उसका एक अलग से ब्रांच बनाते हैं जिसमें हम सिर्फ बीच वाले में टेबल डालेंगे और बाद में हम उसको क्या करते हैं मर्ज कर देते हैं ताकि फिर सही आ जाए टेस्ट करने के बाद इससे क्या होता है हमारा जो पहले का कोड है वो ख़राब नहीं होता है कि उसी में घिचपिच हो गई है और एक और चीज़ है कि इससे हमारा जो दूसरा कोड है वो आराम से टेस्ट भी हो जाता है तो अभी तो जब हम काम कर रहे थे अभी ब्रांच के लिए बस इतना समझ लो कि जिस प्रोजेक्ट पे तुम काम कर रहे हो उस प्रोजेक्ट से अगर तुम्हें कुछ चेंजेस करने हैं तो तुम उस प्रोजेक्ट को क्या करोगे उस प्रोजेक्ट को कॉपी करोगे एंड देन उस प्रोजेक्ट के जिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट में चेंज करने हैं वो वहाँ पे चेंज करके फिर उन दोनों को मर्ज कर दोगे सो द सिमिलर इज विद द ब्रांच कि अच्छा, वो क्या करता है
तो एक तरीके से क्लोन बनाता है अपने हमारे प्रोग्राम का
हाँ ये क्लोन बना देता है तुम जिससे हाँ. भी क्लोन बनाओगे हाँ जो मेन ब्रांच जैसे तुम मैंने जो भी अभी लिखा है उसका क्लोन बना देगा एंड जो भी चेंजेस करने उस क्लोन में करो एंड अगर वो क्लोन तुम्हारा सही चल रहा है तो अपने मेन वाले में तुम मर्ज कर दो सो बेसिकली दिस कमांड इज टू चेंज द ब्रांच सपोज कि मैं मेन वाले में काम कर रही हूँ या फिर मैं अपनी क्लोन वाली में काम कर रही हूँ सो ये है उसके लिए राइट नाउ आफ्टर दिस आई एम एडिंग माई बोथ द रिपोजिटरी माई लोकल विद माई दिस गेटअप सो फॉर दैट आई विल यूज git remote add origin this command and the similar one will be written in your account also where you have created this repository
ma'am ye main wala nahi karna
no because we are not working with the branch now so you can skip that main बेसिकली हम मास्टर पे काम कर रहे हैं सी है इट इज रीडिंग मास्टर ब्रांच का नाम मास्टर है तो तुम ये चाहो तो कर सकते हो इट ब्रांच माइनस एम मेन बट इसे बट अगर नहीं कर रहे हो तो यहाँ पे तुमको मास्टर लिखना पड़ेगा बिकॉज यू आर इन द मास्टर ब्रांच
हाँ
ओके मैम कैन यू ब्रांच वंस अगेन मैम इट ब्रांच
Branch is something like whenever you are making, if you are making a project and now you want to change something in the project, you will not directly change that. What you will do, you will clone that project and after cloning that project, you will change there whatever changes you want to make and then you will merge. And that what the cloning you did is what is similar what a branch is. Basically, you made a branch.
Okay, no, clear.
Okay, so if you want to, yes?
Ma'am, I'm not getting the option of that git bash here in the folder where it is open.
This means that you have not installed the git bash properly.
But ma'am, I just opened it using the Windows panel and git bash and then I even did that email work and username one also.
चेक इट अगेन यू विल बी गेटिंग देयर किसी फोल्डर पे सेलेक्ट करके मत करो इसको जस्ट यहाँ पे सिंपल राइट क्लिक करके करो
मैम
यस
मैम आई वाज अर्लियर यूजिंग मैम लाइक आई एम यूजिंग विंडोज 11 ना
यस
सो इट वाज नॉट डायरेक्टली शोइंग मी आल्सो दिस ओपन गिट बैश वी हैव टू फर्स्ट सेलेक्ट द ऑप्शन ऑफ शो मोर ऑप्शंस इन दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑप्शन इट शोज द ऑप्शन ऑफ गिट बैश
Okay, you can do like that also.
Yes, ma'am, got it. Thank
ma'am,
you.
Ma'am, can you tell us about the master and...
Yes, actually, these are the two branches. Currently, we are working in the master. Branch is something like that, similar to tree. You are in the master branch. And this is telling you that don't do this in the master branch. Do this in the main branch. So that's why we want that. कि तुम मेन ब्रांच पे शिफ्ट कर जाओ सो इफ यू डू नॉट वांट टू शिफ्ट इन द मेन ब्रांच तुम नई ब्रांच बना के नहीं जाना चाहते हो देन यू कैन स्किप दिस पार्ट एंड जस्ट राइट इन द आगे जहाँ भी मेन आता है वहाँ पे बस मास्टर लिख देना, तो इससे क्या होगा कि तुम्हारी एक ही ब्रांच बनी रहेगी.
मैम फेटल आ रहा है मैम ये गिट रिमोट ऐड ओरिजिन करने के बाद. एक्सक्यूज मी मैम.
यस
मैम ये आफ्टर एडिंग दिस गिट रिमोट ऐड ओरिजिन फेटल दिखा रहा है.
स्क्रीनशॉट
शेयर करना प्लीज.
Ma'am, after the git push, the last command, it is asking for me to sign in.
Yes, it will ask for the sign in. Either you sign in the browser or you use the token. So choose the sign in option in the browser and it will automatically detect.
Yes, ma'am, done.
Done? Okay. Be clear with the branch because we are here in the master branch. So if you want to shift, you want to create new branch, then only write this and then you can here use the main. Otherwise use master here.
Ma'am, remote add origin push karta hai kya wo file?
Nahi, actually ye jo tumhari repository bani hai GitHub mein, wo tumhari local wali se connect ho chuki hai ab. तो आप जो भी तुम चेंजेस करोगे तुम यहाँ डायरेक्टली भेज सकते हो.
मैम बट ये शो ओके मैम मुझे दिख नहीं रहा जो गिटहब वाले मेरी प्रोफाइल है उस पे दिख नहीं रहा कहीं पे.
यस बिकॉज़ यू हैव नॉट पुश्ड द चेंजेस येट. यू हैव जस्ट एडेड अ लाइक यू हैव जस्ट टोल्ड योर सिस्टम दैट द गिट रिपोजिटरी व्हिच यू आर वर्किंग ऑन लोकली इज सेम एज और इज सपोज्ड टू पॉइंट टू द गिट रिपोजिटरी अवेलेबल ऑन गिटहब. But you have not pushed your changes which are available on your system to online, so that is why it is not showing your changes there.
Okay sir, thank you.
We will do that. Pravendra Singh, see it is showing that you have you are saying that after using the git commit command your system is showing that it had five files changed and 223 insertions. So 223 insertion is like I think a number of changes which were inside your txt file or something like that. So it is just showing it a number of changes which you have done.
Okay, thank you sir.
So
we have connected our local repository to here GitHub repository. Now what you have to do, you have to upload the changes which you have made in your local. So you have to write git push minus u origin and here there is a name of the branch. So what is written here is the name of the branch, you can write here. So I've written the master and by doing this, yes.
Sure. Come on, you can continue.
Okay.
Please share these screenshots who are facing some fatal error or something like that. And Prakar, did you choose login with a browser thing or the other option? Prakar,
the other option.
See, you are supposed to log in with your browser, but because GitHub recently changed some of its policies and if you are choosing the other options then you'll have to go to your profile and create a personal access token. So you can try the git push origin command again and if it provides you with the option to choose the browser option then please select the browser option and then log in through your browser. And if it doesn't give that then you can contact me after class because it will take some time to create your personal access token and I'll explain this personal access token thing and then you can use this.
Sir, could you please repeat the command that we can use to check our username? Git config something. List.
Git space config space user dot name.
Excuse me, sir. Hello.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. I was asking yes, like yes. Now I have clicked on like the second part, sign in by browser. Now it's asking for authorized Git credential manager.
Yes, you can authorize it.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. See, click the green button, authorize Git credential manager, and it will authorize it. And then after that, you'll be able to push your code. And same for Srishti. And then,
sir, I'm not getting this browser.
So now my Git and GitHub are connected.
Did you get the? Was your push operation successful?
Yes, sir. It's showing it's successful in that Git bash.
Okay, then you can go to GitHub again and go to your same repository, and you can see that all the files which you just created on your local system are now available on GitHub website as well.
Where, sir? Projects.
When you go to GitHub, you can click on your profile, and then it will show the repositories option, where it will show all the repositories which you have created. And there you can see the repository which you just created, and you'll see that all the local files which you created are now present on GitHub as well. Can we merge 2-3 main?
Sir, remote origin already exists, bata raha
hai. Okay, then you have added a remote origin. You can just go with git push command, and if it is showing some error, then you can share this screenshot in the chat, and I'll help you. Sir, my push command is not working. What do I do? Ashmita, can you please share the screenshot? And I'll
excuse me, sir.
Git push command.
Yes. Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
Sir, after the push command, I'm getting a prompt like this: application require one of the following version of .NET framework.
Yes, this is happening with me also.
Which one?
I'm downloading it right now. Ma'am, after the push command. This is showing that this application requires one of the following version of the .NET framework, and some versions are written.
Yeah, can you please just share the screenshot? I think there was some issue with your installation, so I want to see the screenshot.
Sir,
yes, Srishti, this is correct.
Sir, yes. I had shared you the screenshot. It is showing me remote potential palette.
Just a second. I think this is git commit 1.5 remote git push origin master. Yes, is it taking too long? Who is this? Ashmita Tripathi. After clicking enter.
Sir, it's showing remote already exists. What do we do after that?
You can just go to the git push command. If it is saying that remote already exists, then you can skip the remote add command. And if it is showing some error, then you can tell me again. This application requires one of the following .NET frameworks. We want to please click on yes and download the .NET framework version. It will download the framework version, and then after that it should work.
Deepak
Kumar, I guess.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes,
sir, I have done this, and now it's showing my whatever I have written in text file, it's showing on my account of GitHub. Now code is
it just means that you have successfully uploaded the code there. After this, you can also you can add members in the same repository, and then you can collaborate with your friends as well. I don't think we'll be able to take that today, and we'll have to take it into tomorrow's class. But yeah, someone else was asking something.
Sir, actually,
please ask out one by one.
Sir, yes. After doing that Git push one, it's showing error.
What error? Can you please share it in the chat box?
Sir, failed to push some reference.
Yeah,
sir, same error.
Okay. Yeah, then someone please share this screenshot in the chat box. error failed to push some reference to okay git push origin. See, you have like type the command wrong, spelling mistake. There is a spelling mistake.
Sir, I just
copied
it.
Who is this? No, you can see the spelling of your master. It's M-A-S-T-E-R-N, but it should be M-A-S-T-E-R. Akriti, origin does not appear to be a Git repository. Git, see, you have not added the repository correctly. Git remote add, you wrote the spelling wrong there. So please, do that command again, git remote add origin, and then continue with the steps.
Excuse me, sir.
Anyone who is facing the net, yes.
Sir, Asmita this side. Sir, it has still not responded.
Okay, Asmita, just a second. Okay? I'll come back to you. I'll come back to you. Anyone who is facing the net framework problem, please just install the net framework and it should start working. And those for those who like GitHub is taking too long to respond, please wait. I'll come back to you. And other than that,
sir,
git commit, git add origin, git commit add origin. Yes,
sir. It's saying support for password authentication was removed on 30th. August
13,
2021, please use a personal access token instead.
Yes. See, please use the push command again. And when you use the push command again, choose the option for logging in through browser, because recently GitHub changed its policy and now you cannot enter your password through terminal directly and you have to create a personal token for that. So it will take more time. That is why please log in using your browser. Okay.
Sir.
Browser.
Yes. Yes. See, what you can do is you can write the git push hyphen u origin master command again. And when you do that, then it will again show you the prompt for logging in. And when it shows the shows you a prompt for logging in.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir. Hello. Sir, I'm done with the git commit hello world wala thing, and it has I was lost at lost connection after that. So what I'm supposed to do after that git commit thing?
After git commit, you have to add a remote origin.
Okay.
So for that, you can just go to your GitHub repository which you have created.
Right.
Then you can use this command git remote add origin. And then the link which is given there, HTTPS link. First click on HTTPS over there. Not the link of the repository. Kamakshi, can you please go to that GitHub page?
Sir, which GitHub page?
Where it shows the SSH link and HTTPS link, GitHub repository.
Yes, sir.
Sir? Yes, there was someone.
If you created the repository, can we leave then?
Please wait for a few more minutes.
Yes, sir. What I have to do next?
Hello, sir. This is Prakar.
Sir, it's showing me GitHub GitHub link there on the website. HTTPS.
Yeah, you can just copy that link and then use the git remote add origin command. Okay. And then after that, after adding the origin, you can git push hyphen u origin main. And when you do the origin main thing, see one more thing, all those who are facing some reference issue thing, that is because the branch which you have named on your in your git repository is master. But when you are using this git push hyphen u origin command, you are typing in main. Instead of main, type master. If it is showing master in blue brackets, then you have to type master. And if it is showing main, then you have to type main. Git push hyphen u origin master.
Sir, right now, after what is the command I have to use? Git add origin something you said. I forgot the command.
Yeah, git remote add origin. See, it is also available on screen. Git remote add origin. Last second command.
More. And then I have to paste the link, right? I have to paste the link after that. No?
Yeah. Yes. And for pasting the link, you can right click there.
Okay. NGW paste and enter. So did not show anything after that.
Sorry.
It did not show anything. Done with the add origin thing. What do I have to do in it next?
After add origin thing, you have to git push hyphen u origin master. If it is showing master in your blue brackets, and if it is showing main, then you have to write main.
Done with the master, then.
After that, I think it will ask you for a login, and after you log in, your code will get, you will get a similar message as showing as it is shown on this screen, and your code will be code will then get pushed to repository.
Sir, in the .NET framework, we have to download which one? .NET framework runtime or developer pack?
You can just click on yes, and I think it will automatically start downloading your .NET framework.
Sir, actually it's saying.
Sir, it is redirecting it to the .NET Microsoft website. It is not directly.
Can you please share the link here, and I'll tell you what version you can download.
Yes, sir.
Link in the chat box. Yes. Okay, so
hello sir, this is Prakar. Sir, actually I am getting option of token authentication ID.
Hello sir.
Yes.
That's sir, it is not showing anything after I have written git push u origin masters hyphen master.
Is it taking too long? But not.
It is showing nothing, sir. It is showing nothing on the screen.
Okay, then just wait. I'll come back to you later. Akriti, just write in your username, and after that it will probably ask for your password. And if you enter password and it doesn't work, then come back to me. I think it might work. And if it doesn't, then you'll have to create a personal access token.
Sir, actually it's saying that failed to push some refs. So showing an error.
Because you must have given a wrong branch name. You might have given main instead of master or something like that. Can you please show your screen, Chuck?
Excuse me, sir.
All those who are facing issues, please raise your hand so that we can solve everyone's issues one by one, because this is creating too much chaos.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, after doing that master thing,
at browser,
I sent you the photo. Could you please check what to do after that? 5111 Aniket. Aniket.
5111 Aniket. Okay. Remote origin you unknown.
Yes, sir. This one.
Remote origin already exists, and then see, you have to git push. You don't have you are writing the command wrong. It's git push hyphen u origin master.
Git push.
Yes, it's okay. Git push hyphen u origin master.
Sir, I have also sent a photo, sir. The error photo.
Sir, I have also shared the photo.
Yes, one by one. Can you please name yourself?
Sir, one first.
Those who are having error due to the branch, please Nikita? See whatever branch is written here.
Nikita, instead of writing main, just write master at master. Replace main with master.
Okay sir.
See, the thing is, what you are doing here is you are pushing all your code into a branch. So main is the name of your branch, but since over here you have created your branch with the name master, and that is why it is showing reference error, because it cannot find the branch main since you have not created it. So just replace the main with master.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Facing reference issues. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Hello, sir.
What was your roll number? Can you please repeat?
Sir, 4170 Vanshvat, sir.
4170. Can you please share your screenshot again?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I have done with the command git push hyphen u region. Sir, after that a pop-up came which was saying sign in on GitHub.
Yeah, then in that pop-up, please select the browser option. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, after that, I should wait for your next command or I may proceed.
No, no, you can proceed. You have to log in, and after that, after logging in, it will push your code.
Okay, sir.
Hello, sir.
Sir, I've sent the photo again, sir.
Hello, sir. Sir, I am getting the error author identity unknown.
Just a second. 41701, right?
Yes, sir.
Git push happen new origin master. Repository not found. HTTPS number found. Okay. Title error. Git remote add. Git push happen new. Can you please write git remote and send this screenshot in the chat box once?
Git remote.
Yeah, just git remote.
Git remote.
Aniket, you have done the same git push hyphen u origin master.
Sir, I'm not doing anything actually. I'm not able to type.
Error arise, sir.
Can you share the above commands which you have used?
So the dollar sign is removed, sir. That is why I'm thinking.
Just a second. It is taking too long. Git push hyphen origin master. All those if GitHub is taking too long, then just please wait. I'll tell you what you can do after this.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, after typing git init in it, I am getting permission denied.
Permission denied, like for what?
I just gave the command git init in it.
Okay. Please share the screenshot. Nikhil Kumar, just a second, then I'll come back to you. Nikhil Kumar, you have also selected the second option for logging in. Please select the browser option. Just type in git push hyphen u origin master again. It will show you the login option and select the browser option.
Sir, author identity unknown. Sir, kya karu?
Ek baar screenshot dikhana kya aa raha hai wahan pe.
Sir, abhi set kiya screenshot.
Naam kya hai?
Subham.
And number, roll number. 3149.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir. Sir, my name is Nikhil Kumar. I just lost the connection. What were you saying?
Nikhil, please use the git push hyphen origin master command again. And when it asks for authorization, select the browser option. Authorized with your browser.
सर ब्राउजर में लॉग इन कर दिया पर अब कोड कैसे चेक करें कि वेबसाइट में अपलोड हो गया
सर व्हेन आई क्लिक ऑन द ब्राउजर इट इज शोइंग ऑथराइज ग्रिड क्रेडेंशियल मैनेजर
यस जस्ट क्लिक ऑन ऑथराइज एंड देन आफ्टर दैट इट विल ऑथराइज यू सक्सेसफुली
एंड यस इट इज
आफ्टर दैट यू कैन सी दैट योर कोड इज गुड कोड विल गेट पुश्ड टू योर रिपोजिटरी एंड देन यू कैन गो टू योर गिटहब रिपोजिटरी एंड सी दैट योर कोड इज अवेलेबल देयर
एक्सक्यूज मी सर
Yes.
Sir, I am 4105. I have sent one screenshot, sir. Sir, after that .NET framework, I clicked on no twice. Then after that, after the dollar sign, it is my name is coming instead of git dollar, and then my name Aditya is coming on that git prompt command.
41. Just a second. Aditya, right?
Yes, sir.
Git push support for support for password authentication thing, right?
Yes, sir. Sir, after that also, see, I have sent one more screenshot.
Yes, I'm seeing your last screenshot. You can just backspace your name, will get delete your name from there. But see, please write the git push hyphen u origin master command again, and it will again ask you for password authentication. Then you have to select the browser option, okay?
Sir, but after that,
After the authorization, how can I check my code? Which you said, like, do I have to go to the repository?
After authorization, first check if your code got pushed from the it should show a successful message, something like enumerating this many changes and something like that. And
sir,
then you can also
swing to GitHub branch master setup to track remote branch master from origin, something like that. Counting objects, enumerating objects, three done. Counting objects, writing objects, three done. Something.
Okay. Just a minute for all those who are facing issues. Please wait. Kamakshi, कितनी पीपीटी बची हुई है अभी? कितना पार्ट बचा हुआ है आज का?
So only two slides.
क्या-क्या बचा हुआ है? एक बार दिखाना.
Sir, the workflow. I have to explain the workflow. How we have worked. Git add. And then few commands and the difference between Git and GitHub.
Okay, see, like all those who are facing problems can wait and others can leave if you are done. We'll extend this class tomorrow and complete this. And all those who are facing problems can stay here. Okay, then this is.
Sir, can you share the PPT?
Yes, we'll share the PPT in the chat.
Sir, author identification unknown error.
एक बार last में screenshot भेजना थे. अच्छा ठीक है, मेरे को मिल गया.
Sir, किया है 3149.
Yes, author identity git commit hyphen m initial commit. Try writing. I think you didn't perform the git config command and everything else. And
yes, sir.
You are using did you perform the git config command? Git config your username and your that is why it is showing author identity unknown, because you have not configured your authorization identity.
Okay, sir.
So first perform those commands.
Sir, I have shared the PNG, sir. 4170 one shot, sir.
Yes, just a second. Nikhil, just write in your username and then if it asks for a password, then do it.
Sir, I had written it 2 to 3 times. It's showing that again that support for password authorization was removed from the audience.
Okay, then. Just a second. For all those who it is showing password authorization thing, you can wait. I'll explain you how you can do it. And anyone else who is facing some other issue?
Yes, sir. I have shared the screenshot.
Sir,
5111.
I also shared.
Okay, 5111, please share your screenshot again, one by one.
Okay, sir, wait.
Sir, I'm getting permission denied.
Sir, in my case, I mean on the browser, it's coming that authentication section. But when I'm opening this git bash, then it's showing repository not found.
Okay, just a second. You might have given the wrong link or something like that. Nikita, yes, you have done it correctly. You can go to GitHub and see that your code is also available there. And I think once you have also done it correctly and your code must be there on GitHub.
It is now showing me username for github.com. A window has popped up. Username for.
Who is this? Vansh?
Yes, sir, I am Vansh.
Vansh, you have done this part, right?
Yes, sir, I have done.
Yeah, then you don't have to get the username for password. It got authorized. You can go to github.com and you can see that in your repository, all the local changes which you did on your system are now also available on your GitHub repository.
Sir, how can I do that? Actually, I'm not aware of how to check on the repository.
open your Chrome browser, go to github.com, then go to your profile. From there, you'll get the option to see your repositories. Then click on that option and all your repositories will be shown. Then just select the repository which you just created. And then you can see that all the changes which you made locally are there. So you're also done.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. It is done. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Sir, my authentication was succeeded, but sir, when I opened Git Bash, it is showing that repository not found.
Okay. Can you share the screenshot?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, 5111. I shared the photo.
Yeah, 5111. Aniket Pandey.
Yes, sir.
Aniket, I think, can you please share your git remote add origin command? I think your issue is from there. So.
Okay, sir.
Sir, can I leave the meeting, sir, if I'm done?
Yeah, all those who have successfully like pushed their codes can leave. We'll continue the remaining part from here only tomorrow.
Sir, on my GitHub profile, it is showing two commits and it is showing my comment hello world. That is what it is showing there.
Yeah.
It's fine,
Excuse me, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, yes, who is this?
Sir, Mayank.
Thanks, sir. Thank you.
2130.
Yes, Mayank.
Yes, sir. Sir, it was earlier showing some codes like which we were copying and then using it, but now it's not showing after it started showing my project.
Just a second, Mayank. Can you share the screenshot? I mean, I couldn't get your question.
Like I'm just saying like my system is working properly and everything is good, but earlier it was showing some codes which we were copying like git push you origin master, but now it's not showing in GitHub all those codes.
If it got pushed, it will show it on GitHub. You are probably checking it on in wrong repository or at wrong location.
Okay, sir.
You can just go to your profile and see all your repositories.
Okay, sir.
Sir, 5